Okay, so let me show you this, what I'm doing right now. I didn't want to just put this straight on the plywood and then put a bolt through it, because that tubing on this unit here is actually, I mean, it's strong, but it's also thin walled tubing. And a bolt, you tighten a bolt down, and where do you stop? And you'll crush that tubing with a bolt, and you know, coming through the bottom. So I wanted to create like a 90, I mean, like a saddle washer. You know, you can buy these, you know, that fit the profile. And, you know, the good thing is this is exactly 1 inch tubing here. So what I've done here on the bottom is I've gone ahead and, you know, I had everything laid out and pre-drilled my holes where the spots were first, you know, because otherwise if I routed through this, I wouldn't be able to find it. So I just cut a small half round channel there. And, you know, really carefully laid it out. And my marks front to back were just identical. I mean, they were just, you know, the whoever jigged that thing up at the factory in Taiwan, they did a really good job, because it was perfect front to back. So I was able to do this with the edge guide. Now, the distance this way, I had to make custom cut fits this way, you know, because these are not exactly the same as those. They were a little off, and it was probably just because of, you know, I'm not sure, the housing or what have you underneath it, or, you know, whatever they wanted to do there, I'm not sure. But what I'm getting ready to do is I want to cut this one here with this. But the way you have to, the way you set this up is you, and the router's unplugged right now, so you take your router, and I've got a V-point bit in it. You know, so there's my very carefully laid out marks. I got scribe marks, I got crosshatch. I've already drilled through with a really small size wire drill bit. So I've got it located. I've got the whole location located. So now I've got this V-point bit in here, and what I want to do is I just want to use that bit to set the router distance with the edge guide exactly to that scribe line. It's a real easy way to do it, and, you know, be real accurate. So a lot of times I'll tighten this down and it will have moved just a little bit, so I'll go back to the micro adjustment on the back of this beautiful Festool thing here. So that looks perfect, splitting the line right there. Now, leaving the fence on, you know, I don't want to mess with it. I want to take that V-bit out, and you know, I always like to use my cheater bar here, so I don't have to grunt and strain. I don't have to worry about this depth here, because I'm going to set the depth the same way I did the other side, you know, using the nice features on this router. So I'll get it just the same. So you push this down and zero it out and raise it up to, I'm going 5 millimeters. And I've got some plunge marks here. I've got a mark here and here. So that's where I'm going to stop and start and stop my cut. meant to say I was going to cut to about the halfway point. Okay, so let me drill these guys out to, I'm going to countersink first on the, I need to drill these out to 5/16 and put a countersunk bolt going through and then check my fit, see what kind of fit I have. And then I need to just make the top pieces. I'll probably just make them out of plywood too, I think, maybe. Let me think about that and I'll let you know here in a minute. So I just laid out a piece of plywood scrap and these are going to be my four half curved washers on the top so I don't crush that pipe. And then I can tighten that thing down the way I like to and not worry about it. So I did the same thing. I just laid it out. Then I used that little bit right there to come up to find my centering line. First I drilled my holes, my locating holes. Now I'm going to go ahead and just route my half round bottom. And then I'll just drill it out and then cut it apart. Okay, let's see how this guy fits. So what I did here is, after I opened my holes up to, 21/32, is that what I did? I'm sorry, 21/64, so a 64th over 5/16, and then I countersunk it with, just one of my big countersinks. So let me see if I can get this. Always in here without them falling out. I just wanted there to be enough looseness that. Okay, so that's the front. Let's see how this fits. Come on, baby. Oh, like a glove. That is just, that's just perfect. This bolt here may be just a little bit too tall. I may have to go ahead and cut it off. I don't know if I can get a nut on there with that plastic. That one just fell out. That's what that was because I slid it off the table. Oh man, that is some perfect alignment there. Careful measuring and marking, layout, it's everything. See, I didn't even need to go that far, but it's okay. I barely took anything away from the strength. Okay, so let me go cut these guys apart, and then I'll have my top pieces that can lock down, and we'll see what the fit looks like. So here are these pieces. So those will last forever. That Baltic birch, it's going to get saturated with some of my oil mix, and oh, sweet. Oh, excuse me. Thanks for watching. We have woodworking plans available in our store and will continue to add more. Each set of plans corresponds with a free video series available on YouTube.